Thank you. Well, good afternoon or evening, everybody, and welcome to Collingwood Collegiate's commencement exercises for the class of 2022. My name is Aaron Bell. I'm a music teacher here at CCI, and I have the honor of serving as Master of Ceremonies for our second ceremony today. Just to let you know, we have a professional photographer from Edge Imaging joining with us today at the ceremony. This way, guardians, you can kind of stay seated in those comfortable chairs. Each graduate will have their photo taken while on stage, and those photos will be available to you. You can receive your digital copy, Compliments of CCI, by logging into Edge Imaging's website and downloading it. All the information has been given on our website under Commencement, and it's in the Grade 12 Google Classroom as well, too. At this time, I would invite everybody to stand as we invite our platform party, honored guests, staff, and community presenters into the room. Ladies and gentlemen, would you please welcome the graduating class of 2022. Come on, keep clapping, everybody. They're almost there. All right, thank you. You may be seated. First of all, I'd like to extend a heartfelt welcome to all our graduates, staff, guardians, and guests. We are so happy to have you join us for this special ceremony as we celebrate the graduating class of 2022. Before we begin, there are a few housekeeping items. The first has to do with fire exits. I think the graduating class can figure that one out. But there are some on this side, at the rear, and at this side as well. But it's important that you know where to exit in the event of a fire, but we don't foresee that happening. Before we begin our ceremony, I think it's very, very important that we recognize some of our amazing donors that have made this event possible for us. We have Collingwood Home Hardware and Loblaws for allowing us to borrow all of these beautiful planters for the stage and Clearview Nursery for the additional greenery as well. We also want to thank Mr. Young and the ComTech team for recording this presentation live for guests at home watching on YouTube through our CCI website. At this point, I would like to now introduce our platform party and honored guests. And I would ask that as I introduce each one, they stand and we can give a wave. And if you'd like to applause to honor their presence with us today, that would be great. First, I'd like to introduce our superintendent for Simcoe County District School Board, Mr. Michael Giffen. Our trustees from the Simcoe County District School Board, Tanya Snell. Your very own principal, Mr. Kurt Davidson. Our vice principal, Mr. Michael Fogarty. We have Mayor of Wasaga Beach, Nina Bifolci. And Collingwood's acting deputy mayor, Marianne McLeod. And on stage as well, we have our 2022-2023 Students' Council president, Natalie Sipchenko. So to officially begin our ceremonies, I would like to invite two very special graduates onto the stage. We have Caitlin Burns, who will read the land acknowledgement, and then Maddie Salcedo will lead us in the singing of our national anthem. At this point, I would ask everybody to please rise.
Hi there, I'm Caitlin Burns, and I'll be reading your land acknowledgement. Sorry, Mr. Bell, could you? Oh, never mind, I got it this time, we're good. The Simcoe County District School Board acknowledges that we are situated on the traditional land of the Anishinaabeg people. The Anishinaabeg include the Ojibwe, Odawa, and Potawatomi nations, collectively known as the Three Fires Confederacy. We are dedicated to honoring Indigenous history and culture, and are committed to moving forward in the spirit of reconciliation and respect with all First Nation, Métis, and Inuit people.
I'm Madison, and I'll be singing "O Canada."
O Canada, our home and native land, true patriot love in all of us common, with glowing hearts we see thee rise, the true north strong and free. From far and wide, O Canada, we stand on guard for thee. God keep our land glorious and free. O Canada, we stand on guard for thee. O Canada, we stand on guard for thee.
Thank you, ladies. I'd now like to invite our principal, Mr. Kurt Davidson, to address us.
I don't have this memorized, so I'm going to look down, folks. Good afternoon. Thank you, Collingwood Collegiate and the Commencement Committee, for organizing this event and inviting me to speak. I've had the privilege of working as the principal of Collingwood Collegiate for the past year and a half, and it is my honor to represent the administrators who've worked with the graduating class throughout their time here. On a personal note, this is my seventh time now participating in a Collingwood Collegiate graduation ceremony. Today being one, five times in recent years when I had the privilege of being a vice principal and principal here at CCI, and actually at my own graduation from CCI some time ago in the past. To the graduates, I say you do have a great education, a great educational background, now having learned at CCI. But I suggest that you do not stop learning because you now have that diploma to display proudly on your wall. You are leaving CCI and commencing on a new stage of life with a myriad of possible directions to pursue. As you move into the world of work or other formalized education settings, you do so in an age of technological development that is unprecedented in human history. Worldwide communication, social media, and access to information are now so commonplace as to make them mundane. A few years from now, many of you may be working at jobs that don't even exist today. Adaptability to change with an expectation of ongoing learning will be your currency for fulfilling life. Having said that, I urge you to give serious thought to what is really important: a focus on money, fame, beauty, social standing, will not stand the test of time. What will make a difference in your life will be how you make a difference in others' lives. Will your compassion, your empathy, your kindness, your generosity inspire others to emulate your example? Will your integrity, your prudence, your courage, and sacrifice empower or encourage others? How many people you know and friends that you have will not be as important as how many will feel a lasting loss when you are gone. Plan your future and live your life knowing that your character and your contribution to a better world will be more substantial than all the things you collect or may own. I hope in your lifetime that even your gender or your skin color will be irrelevant, and where you come from will have no importance. It'll be your actions that will define you and who you are. It'll be your service to others that will sustain you and nurture our world. It'll be your choices that make your life, your future, one of impact and lasting significance. May you have a long and fulfilled life with happiness and good health, and may you choose a life that is truly important and filled with lasting meaning. Thank you.
Thank you, Principal Davidson. I'd next like to introduce Tanya Snell, trustee for the Simcoe County District School Board, to bring greetings.
Thank you very much. I am honored to bring you a congratulatory message on behalf of the Simcoe County District School Board. Let's be honest, the last 2.5 years have been nothing but the dog's breakfast for you guys. As students, parents, and staff, you've had to pivot in a nanosecond to the pandemic. You should be incredibly proud of yourselves for having gotten through it and to your success today. Congratulations and thank you goes to all the faculty and family members who helped you to achieve this goal. It is their day to celebrate as well. To the graduating students, you have shown incredible resiliency, and now you're off to the next part of your journey. Whether you're going on to post-secondary, doing a gap year, joining the workforce, or heading into a much-needed trade, we know that you're going to have great success. Enjoy this day and your upcoming summer, and we wish you the very best for your next adventure ahead. Thank you.
Thank you, Trustee Snell. I would like to invite Michael Giffen, our Area 5 Superintendent of Education for the Simcoe County District School Board.
Thank you, Mr. Belt. Good afternoon, everyone. Principal Davidson, CCI staff, family, friends, honored guests, graduates. I'm pleased to join you today, and on behalf of Director John Dance and my school board colleagues, congratulations on this, your graduation day. Like you, I'm a CCI grad from 1988, and together we are written into a rich and storied history of our school and our community. Like the many graduates before us, be proud of your accomplishments. Be confident in who you are and yourself. Your confidence will always serve you well as you make plans and you take your next steps. Be mindful of your personal strengths. As the individuals you are, your knowledge, your skill, and your experience will always guide you. Be grateful to those who have shaped you and continue to support you. Consider the positive impact that someone else has had on you and your life as a student. Remember what that person, whether it be an educator, an education support staff member, a community member, a family member, or a friend, remember what they've taught you. Remember how they make you think. Remember how they make you feel. And remember that they always show that they care. Be mindful of that, and I encourage you to take the opportunity sometime when it's the right time for you to pay that forward to someone else in your life. Thank you to CCI administrative team and to the staff for teaching and preparing your students and for supporting their achievements and their success. To every parent in the gym today, every grandparent, every family member, every friend, every guardian who continue to guide and support your children, thank you. Because as parents, our children will always be our children, regardless of age and regardless of circumstance. Graduates, despite the significant challenges in the last 2 years, you've done remarkable work. You should be very proud of that. Keep moving forward. Keep your mind open. Keep looking for new doors to open, new things to do, and always be curious, because your curiosity will lead you down new paths. Please accept my congratulations and best wishes for a safe and happy summer. Take care, be well, and thank you for having me today.
Well, graduates, it's the moment you've all been waiting for. Parents, this is truly the moment you've all been waiting for. Yeah, there we go. That's right. You know, it is an exciting time. Maybe it shouldn't be that exciting, but it is exciting to see our kids move on and just get to that point. They've worked extremely hard over 4 years, and grads, we're very, very proud of you. As the graduates are starting to move into their place, I would like to remind everybody that out of respect of each and every graduate here, we would like you to remain for the entire program. It might be tempting to leave when your child is done. However, we would like you to stay all the way through. It's going to be a great time of celebration. I want you to just cheer and shout for each one of these kids. They've all worked extremely hard, and we're going to hear lots of great stories about where they're heading off to next. I would like to call upon now Kate Lanis to be one of our first announcers for this section of the program, and also introduce Kurt Davidson and Michael Fogarty up to present the diplomas.
Wow, you're tall. Okay. This is Jason Carl, and he has graduated with his OSSD. Jason is going to be attending the Toronto Metropolitan University to study media production, and it hopes to work in the entertainment industry in the future. Jason is the recipient of the following award, the Blue Mountain Foundation for the Arts Scholarship. This is Ava Keating. Ava would like to thank her amazing family, friend group, and teachers for an awesome high school experience. She will be attending Western University to study business management and organizational studies. She will miss everyone. Thank you. Samantha Keith Weldon has graduated with their OSSD. Samantha will be attending York University to study biology. She wants to thank all of her teachers for the unending support. Samantha is the recipient of the following awards, the Carpe Diem Award and the Zachary Ezra Rollins Award. Landon Kemp has graduated with their Ontario Secondary School Diploma and their Extended French Certificate. Landon will be attending Carleton University to study the Bachelor's of Mechanical Engineering. And before this, he will be traveling. Congratulations. Thank you. This is Davin Kurlicki, and he has graduated with his Ontario Secondary School Diploma and his Extended French Certificate. Davin will be traveling for a year and eventually move on to study psychology. Throughout the next couple of decades, he will continue to show responsibility as the co-leader of the Juicers. Thank you to everyone who has helped him on his journey. Oops. I just dropped something. This is Jade Cobbs, and Jade has graduated with their Ontario Secondary School Diploma. She will be doing an apprenticeship for a mechanic, and she would like to thank her mom, Crystal, and her grade 9 English teacher, Mrs. Lanis. Aw, Jade, and every other teacher who has helped her through the years. Congratulations. This is Ava Koo, and Ava has graduated with their Ontario Secondary School Diploma. Ava will be attending McMaster University to study commerce. She would like to thank her family for all of their support and is excited to start this next chapter at McMaster. Thank you. This is Jamie Corpy, and Jamie has graduated with their Ontario Secondary School Diploma. Jamie will be attending Laurier University to study kinesiology. She would like to become a paramedic or a pediatric nurse. And she would like to thank her parents, her teachers, her coaches for always believing in her, and she can't wait for the next adventure to start and to see where it will take her in the future. This is Corey Koala. Corey has graduated with his Ontario Secondary School Diploma. He will be attending the University of Guelph to study engineering. And he wishes to thank all the CCI staff who taught him and set him up to be successful. Corey is the recipient of the Ontario Secondary School Teachers Federation Bursary. This is Dee Krashenka. Dee has graduated with their Ontario Secondary School Diploma. She's not quite sure what the plans are yet. So a new award was established this year in memory of Kenneth McAlpine. Kenneth was a graduate of CCI and followed his passion in culinary industry and living his life to the fullest. He loved skiing, cooking, biking, the outdoors, and his faith, family, and friends. Kenneth left a lasting impression across Canada as part of Team Giver with longtime friend Ryan LaChapelle. Kenneth was determined to transform children's lives and to be a role model for youth. Believe in yourself to overcome challenges, and it's okay to come in second. Today, the Kenneth McAlpine Memorial Award will be presented by Kenneth's brother Daniel to honor his life and devotion to the others. So this is, and this is Donovan Levins, and he's graduated with his Ontario Secondary School Diploma. He will be returning, or will be attending George Brown Culinary College to study culinary skills. His goal is to become a chef and open up his own restaurant, and he'd like to thank Taylor Swift, Mrs. Sinnott, Peyton Boddicker for inspiring him to always be himself. He is the recipient of the Kenneth McAlpine Memorial Award. Camille Lattimore has graduated with their OSSD. She will be taking a gap year and plans on working. Hi, Elise. And this is Elise Lattimore. Elise has graduated with their OSSD. Elise is also going to take a gap year and plans on working. This is Farah Lawler. Farah has graduated with her OSSD. She is planning on taking a gap year to travel. She would like to thank Mr. Aaron Bell for his persistent words of encouragement and torment. This is Ben LaCour. Ben has graduated with his OSSD. He is attending the University of Guelph to study computer science. Ben is the recipient of the following award, the Featherston Charitable Foundation Computer Science Award. Ben, you need to come back. This is presented. Okay. And this is being presented by Krishya Pirchensky. Okay. This is Kurt LaCour Markwich. Kurt is going to be attending Georgian College to study social work. He would like to thank his grandparents, his brother, his friends for the motivation to get him his best grades. Kurt will be receiving the William Lacey Memorial Award and the Susan P. Wells Scholarship. This is Riley Legault, and he's graduated with his OSSD and his Shazam Construction Red Seal Diploma. He will be studying an apprenticeship in electrical, and he wants to thank Marcel Kruger for being the most fun teacher. Riley is going into an electrical apprenticeship. This is Nolan Leggy, and he's graduated with our Ontario Secondary School Diploma. Nolan will be going into an apprenticeship after school to become an electrician and one day own his own business. And this is my son.
This is Jude Lanis. Jude is attending Laurier University to study music and eventually become a university professor. Jude Lanis is the recipient of the following awards, the Mark Spencer Memorial Scholarship.
Thank you.
and I said I wasn't going to cry. This is Zara Ling, and she's graduated with her OSSD, and she's going to be attending Western to study medical sciences. Zara, oh, wait. Zara, you are the recipient of the Flight Sergeant Harry Hunt Memorial Bursary. Thank you. This is Ben Lippert, and Ben has graduated with their Ontario Secondary School Diploma. Ben is going to be taking a gap year to work and travel. This is Landon Loheed, and he has graduated with his Ontario Secondary School Diploma. Landon is planning on working and helping his family. This is Aaron Magdenberg. He has graduated with his Ontario Secondary School Diploma. He's attending Carleton University to study computer science. Aaron would like to thank his friends and his family. He is the recipient of the following award, the Hydrogen Optimized Award. This is Grant McLeod. He has earned his OSSD. Grant would like to thank all of his friends and family for getting him through school. One person brought joy into his life with Minions, and that person is Max Fittler. Grant is planning on traveling. This is Angelo McPherson. He has graduated with his Ontario Secondary School Diploma. His goal is to join the Army, and he would like to thank all of his coaches and teachers. This is Gemma McPherson, and she has graduated with their Ontario Secondary School Diploma. Gemma would like to thank her teachers that she had the opportunity to meet, and to thank Ms. Carey, as she is excited about what the future holds for her when she takes a year off. This is Sam Mahar, and Sam is going to be exploring some career paths, but is planning on taking a year to volunteer and find himself. Sam has graduated with his OSSD. This is Caden Mansell. Caden has graduated with their OSSD and his Shazam Construction Red Seal Diploma. Caden is going to be attending Georgian College to study electrical techniques. He would like to thank Mr. Ross for helping him discover his passion for working in the electrical field. This is Ella McAleer, and she has graduated with her Ontario Secondary School Diploma. Ella will be attending Wilfrid Laurier to study business. She would like to pursue a Bachelor of Business Administration. This is Hunter McCain, and Hunter has graduated with their Ontario Secondary School Diploma. He will be attending the Guelph University and studying marine and freshwater biology. Hunter would like to thank his mom and dad for pushing him to his limits and always being there for him. He wishes his mom could be here, but he knows she's happy. This is Kayla McCollum. Caleb has graduated with their Ontario Secondary School Diploma. He will be attending Humber College to study computer programming. This is Griffin McCullough, and Griffin has graduated with their Ontario Secondary School Diploma and their Shazam Construction Red Seal Diploma. He would hopefully like to become a welder, and he would like to thank Marcel Kruger for being a good teacher. This is Leah McGlattery, and she has graduated with her OSSD. Leah will be attending Queen's University to study the Bachelor of Science. She's excited to go for the next 4 years. She's had a great time at Collingwood Collegiate Institute and thanks everyone who has made her experience memorable. OGs for life. Leah is the recipient of the following award, the Jim Kilgore Memorial Award. Oh, wow. This is James McInnes, and James has graduated with our Ontario Secondary School Diploma, his construction Red Seal Shazam, and is registered an apprentice with the OAP program. He is going to plan on a 3-year apprenticeship for general carpentry and would like to work long-term for R. Talbot Carpentry. James is the recipient of the following awards: the Featherston Charitable Foundation Building Construction Trade Award and the Building Construction. This is presented by Krzysia Piroszenski. This is Kate McIntosh. Kate has graduated with her OSSD and is attending the University of British Columbia to study psychology in the Okanagan campus. She would like to thank her family, friends, and teachers for helping her get to where she is now. This is Maya McKenzie. Maya has graduated with her Ontario Secondary School Diploma. She'll be attending George Brown College to study business. This is Carter McLean. Carter has graduated with his OSSD and is a registered apprentice in the OYAP program. He is not attending post-secondary, but he hopes to be able to turn his co-op placement into a full-time job. This is Isaac McMaster, who has graduated with his OSSD. Isaac is going to the military, and he would like to thank his friends and family. This is Jaden McNally, and Jaden has graduated with her OSSD. She will be attending Georgian College to study architect technology. She would like to thank Mr. Ross, Mr. Lehman, and Mr. Pierce for helping her get here. This is Lauren Merrill, and Lauren has graduated with her OSSD. Lauren is planning on working next year and hoping to travel. She's leaning towards attending Western the year after and would like to thank her parents for everything that they have done for her for the last 4 years. This is Helen Metherall, and Helen has graduated with her OSSD. Helen will be returning to CCI for a semester and then travel to New Zealand for work. She would like to thank her mom and dad for their love and support throughout high school. This is Mitrakina. She's graduated with their OSSD and her extended French. Alyssa would like to thank her teachers throughout the years for the mentorship and guidance, as well as her friends for being there for her. She'd especially like to thank her mom for always being there for her and encouraging her to go after her dreams. This is Ella Mueller, and Ella has graduated with her OSSD. She will be attending Queen's University to study psychology. Ella would like to thank her family, friends, and teachers for motivating her and giving her support through high school. She will miss everyone this fall. Ella is the recipient of the CCI's Principal's Award. This is Maley Munnings, and Maley has graduated with her OSSD. Maley will be attending Western University to study psychology. She would like to thank her parents for their endless support and her guidance counselor, Kim Carey, for giving her all the resources she needed to be successful. I would now like to have you please give a round of applause for this group of graduates. And our next presenter will be Todd Funston.
Thank you. Elise Muara. Elsie Moir has graduated with her OSSD. Elsie would like to thank her family for their support. Congratulations. Michaela Neeb has graduated with her OSSD. She will be attending George Brown to study child and youth care. Michaela Neeb is taking a year off to travel and then attend George Brown for child and youth care. I would like to say thank you to Mrs. Zago, Ms. Marshall, Kim Kennedy, Mr. Fogarty, and many more. She will be receiving the Carpe Diem Award, the Ottawa United Church Holyrood Memorial Bursary. Paul Nguyen has graduated with his OSSD. He will be attending Laurier for computer science. Congratulations, Paul. Tyler Otteson. Tyler is going to pursue firefighting. Congratulations. Dakota Paisley. Dakota would just like to say thank you to all who showed me what it's like to be a high school student, and I hope to see you all next year. Anthony Page will be attending Royal Military College to study engineering. He would like to thank Mr. Kruger, Ms. Diver, for an amazing time in high school. Would also like to thank Ms. Zago for being an amazing teacher. All this will help him in college. John Parnell. John plans to take a year off to save up for college. He would like to thank Ms. Geyer, Mr. Hammond, Mr. Bremer, Mr. Cockle, and the rest of the teachers at CCI. Kaylee Paul will be attending Humber College for Police Foundations, then to Quebec for CBSA training. Kaylee is the recipient of the Rick Holly Memorial Award. Patrick Paul has received his OSSD with the SHSM Construction Red Steel Diploma and a registered apprentice in the OYAP program. He will be going on to apprenticeship. Patrick is working on his apprenticeship in general carpentry. He would like to thank Mr. Ross for getting him into this field of work. He will be receiving the OYAP award. Graydon Pearson will be attending Fleming College in Computer Engineering Technology. Gray is furthering their education at Fleming College, where they will hope to become a computer technician. Congratulations, Gray. Georgia Pendergast will be working. She would like to thank her son, who was her motivation to keep going, as well as her boyfriend, who was always there to support her. She will be receiving the CCI Alumni Award. Jessica Pereira will be going to work. She's taking a gap year to work. Congratulations. Blake Petit will be attending Brock University in sports management. Blake would like to thank his family and friends for the support throughout high school. He would also like to thank and give special thanks to Mr. Bremer and Mr. High for making class a little more enjoyable. Rain Prosser has graduated with her OSSD. Rain plans on taking a year off to work and travel, and would like to thank her parents for their support. And her mom cannot believe it's been 18 years tomorrow since she's graced us with her presence. Mark Pušić has graduated with his OSSD and also with his SHSM Construction Red Seal Diploma. Mark will be taking an apprenticeship opportunity and pursuing a career as a forestry technician. Rachel Pyatt has graduated with her OSSD. Next year, Rachel is coming back to CCI for a semester, and then she plans to attend Nipissing University for teaching. She would like to thank all of her friends, family, and teachers for the help and encouragement. Aiden Quinn is graduating with his OSSD and with his extended French certificate. Will be attending University of Waterloo to study physical science. Next year, physical science with a major in chemistry. Good job. Connor Ray will be attending an apprenticeship. He has graduated with his OSSD. Connor will be joining the workforce to pursue an apprenticeship opportunity in welding. Would like to thank his grandpa for driving him to school every day. Leah Ray has graduated with her OSSD. She will be attending Western University to study English with a combined business degree. She would like to thank all of her teachers, especially Ms. Kosovich, who inspired her to take this route. She would also like to thank her amazing coaches, Ms. Geyer, Mr. Hammond, Mr. Cockle, and Mr. McCarl, for making high school so enjoyable. Finally, she would also like to thank her parents and her little sister for making things so awesome. She is receiving the Al Cockle English and Athletics Award, presented by Krishia Porochinski. Oh, presented by Mr. Cockle. She's also receiving the Janet Margarita Snell Scholarship. Hannah Reed has received her OSSD. She will be attending Dalhousie University to study health promotion. Hannah will be attending to study health promotion. She hopes to pursue a career in epidemiology in the future, and she would like to thank her friends and family for helping her through these last 4 years. Holly Reed has graduated with her OSSD. She will be attending Seneca as a library and information technician. She would like to become a librarian, wishing well to everyone who showed compassion along the way. And she is the recipient of the Shaw McClellan Scholarship presented by Nicole Scott. Emma Reed has graduated with her OSSD. Emma plans on going to St. Lawrence in January for veterinary technician, then to Guelph University to become a veterinarian. Emma would like to thank her mom for always being her number one supporter. Cade Rennie is graduating with his OSSD with his SHSM Construction Red Seal diploma. Cade is taking a year off to travel to New Zealand and Ireland to play rugby and would like to thank his parents for all the help over the last 4 years, also going to Ireland. Maggie Rhodes has graduated with her OSSD. She'll be attending Ottawa University to study human kinetics. Maggie is going to University of Ottawa to study human kinetics in hopes of being either a chiropractor, physiotherapist, or athletic therapist. Maggie is also going to be a part of the Gigi's varsity swim team as well. Maggie would like to thank Mr. Jones, her parents, and everyone else who has helped her along the way. She is also the recipient of an award, the Bob Comish Blue Mountain Village Award. Tala Riaz. Graduating with his OSSD, would like to thank his parents for all of their support the last few years. Ben Richards has graduated with his OSSD. He's going to an electrical apprenticeship, plans to continue his goal of becoming an electrician through Fanshawe College. would like to thank Mr. Salmon for making class better than it should be. Victoria Richards has graduated with her OSSD. Victoria would like to thank all of her family and friends. She would also like to thank Ms. Zago, Mr. Corrigan, Ms. Wyant, and Ms. Sinnott. Thanks for everything. Olivia Robichek will be attending George Brown. She has graduated with her OSSD. Olivia will be attending George Brown College in downtown Toronto for their accounting program. Hunter Roche has graduated with his OSSD. Hunter is returning to CCI to gain more work experience. Tyler Roche has graduated with his OSSD. Tyler is going to work full-time and train for baseball on his off time and buy a car and travel. Samara Rose has graduated with her OSSD. Samara would like to thank those who have helped her find what she is and become her future self. Emma Rusk has graduated with her OSSD. She will be attending Lakehead University for primary junior education program. Art, like life, has several definitions and interpretations. Art is not, however, will be flawless or revolve around perfection. It fastens growth and evolution. Mr. Vanchise encouraged that growth and taught Emma to be the best version of herself. This inevitably inspired Emma to decide to become an educator, mentor, and friend to her future students. Her next adventure will begin at Lakehead University with the education program. Sydney Russell has graduated with her OSSD. She will be attending Trent University in English literature. Sydney is going to Trent for a dual degree in English literature and law. Cole Sackerty has graduated with his OSSD. He is attending Fanshawe for business next year and would like to thank Mr. Salmon. Clarissa Sahu has graduated with her OSSD and also the SHSM Health and Wellness Red Seal Diploma. She'll be attending Trent University for nursing. She would like to thank Mr. Jones, Mrs. Burke, for always pushing her academic limits. Madison Salcido has graduated with her OSSD and also with the extended French certificate. She will be attending Dalhousie University in the Bachelor of Music. She's excited to be going to Halifax. She wants to thank her amazing teachers and guidance counselors. She is also the recipient of the Velma Cook Award, supported by Celebration Children's Chorus. Hannah Sammons has graduated with her OSSD. She will be attending Lakehead University for social work. Her long-term goal is to be a youth mental health social worker. She would also like to thank her mother for being her number one supporter. Logan Sanchez has graduated with his OSSD. He will be attending Guelph for engineering. Logan is going to Guelph and would like to thank his parents for continual support. Berlin Sargent has graduated with her OSSD. She will be attending Conestoga College to study interior decorating after she plans on taking over her aunt's decor store. She would like to thank her friends and family. Eva Satarova, and will be attending Fanshawe College for Business Marketing. Eva worked really hard and graduated 1 year early to now study business marketing in Fanshawe. She especially wants to thank Ms. Carey, Ms. Taylor Fox, Mr. High, and her grandmother, because without them, none of this would be possible. Christian Sawicki has graduated with his OSSD. Christian plans to be an automotive service tech, specializing in German cars, and one day opening up a shop. Thank you, Ms. McLeod, for all the help, and Mr. Salmon for best math teacher. He will be receiving the Kells Service Center Ideal Supply United Auto Parts Scholarship. Tegan Schneider has graduated with her OSSD. She has graduated also with the Extended French Certificate. She will be attending University of Toronto at the Rotman Commerce Program. She would like to thank her friends and family for supporting her and making the past 4 years memorable. Best of luck to everyone in the future. She will also be receiving the Lieutenant Governor's Community Volunteer Award and the Jozo Wider Memorial Scholarship. Alicia Schrader has graduated with her OSSD. She will be attending the University of Waterloo for Environmental Studies next year, and good luck. Kaylin Scriver has graduated with OSSD. She'll be going to Lakehead University to study education. She is following in the footsteps of her grandparents, who were great teachers. Kaylin would like to thank her family for supporting her throughout high school. Aiden Shaw has graduated with an OSSD. Will be attending University of Guelph for engineering. Congratulations. Sydney Shaw has graduated with her OSSD. She'll be attending Wilfrid Laurier University to study psychology with a Bachelor of Science. Sydney would like to thank her family for being a constant encouragement throughout this stage of life. Emma Scheuer has graduated with her OSSD. She will be attending Queen's University to study general science. She would like to thank her teachers, coaches, and parents for all the support throughout the years. Jackson Simmons has graduated with his OSSD. He's taking a gap year to travel and work. He would like to thank his parents and friends for all of their support. Megan Sims has graduated with her OSSD. Next year, Megan is planning to take a gap year to work and take time to travel. She'd like to thank her friends and family for a memorable 4 years. Mackenzie Seripathane has graduated with her OSSD. Mackenzie will be living in Toronto next year to study cognitive science. She would like to thank her mom for all the money lent and her personal typewriter and for being a real one. This is for Kaylee Paul. Sorry. Mackenzie is also the recipient of the Elsie and Dennis Shadwick Memorial Bursary. Cody Small has graduated with his OSSD. He'll be exploring options. High school was a one-of-a-kind experience. Glad it's done. I'm out. Graydon Smith. Graydon will be getting his OSSD. Would like to come back and share another year of memories. Would like to say thank you to his aunt for driving him every morning and his mother for making way to celebrate. Also, thank you to Mr. Lehman for the pen. Kyle Smith will be receiving his OSSD. He will attend Western University to study environmental science. Kyle would like to thank his mom for editing his essays. Sophia Smith has graduated with her OSSD. She will be attending OCAD to study metal and textiles. And she will become a fashion designer after this. She would like to thank everyone who made her high school experience one to remember. Aiden Stather has graduated with his OSSD. Aiden's plans for next year are to travel and be free. He wants to thank his family and friends for being by his side throughout the years. Emma Strain has graduated with her OSSD. She will be attending Western University to study kinesiology. Aaron Stransky. Aaron is heading to Laurier University to study business administration and earn her BBA. She is the recipient of the Wasaga Beach Women's Business Association bursary presented by Kathy Jakes. Keith Sutherland has graduated with his OSSD. Congratulations, Keith. Now, please give a nice round of applause for this group of graduates. And I would like to invite Amy Bishop for the next group of graduates.
Gabriel Talbot is graduating with his Ontario Secondary School Diploma. Gabe will be doing an apprenticeship and running his own business next year. Congratulations. Congratulations to Tanis Taylor. She has graduated with their Ontario Secondary School Diploma. She will be attending Wilfrid Laurier University to study her Bachelor of Business Administration. Tanis is excited to attend Laurier to study business. She enjoyed her time at CCI and wants to thank her friends and family for sticking by her throughout the 4 years. Go, Owls, go. Braden Thompson is graduating with his secondary school diploma. He will be attending Wilfrid Laurier for business next year. Braden would like to thank his parents and all his sports and academic teachers. Braden is also the recipient of the following awards: Manitou Lodge No. 90, Ronald Dale Culbert, and the Memorial Bursary. Congratulations. Juliette Tremblett is graduating with their Ontario Secondary School Diploma. She plans to work. Juliet will be a nurse and will have freedom to do as she pleases. Congratulations. Maya Turner is going to the University of Ottawa to study Greek and Roman studies with a minor in Celtic studies in the hopes of one day teaching her very own university classics course. Sounds fun. Congratulations. Brianna Von Bommel is graduating with their Ontario Secondary School Diploma. She is moving to Greenwood, Nova Scotia and taking a gap year to work. Some people didn't think she would pass, but she did. Way to go. This wonderful human being is Elise Van Boven. She is graduating with her Ontario Secondary School Diploma. She will be attending Queen's to study the law. Elisa's future goals include law school, and she wants to thank all her teachers for making her 4 years at CCI memorable. Special mention to Coach McCarl for all the time and dedication to high school basketball and Trailblazers. You did it! Woo! Lucas Van Dyne is graduating with his Ontario Secondary School Diploma. He will be attending Georgian Audio, oh sorry, he will be working at Georgian Audio Video full time. He would like to thank Mr. Young, Mrs. McLeod, and Mr. D for a great year. He is also receiving the Hannah Motors Sales Award. Way to go. Nicole Van Dyne is taking a year off, but is graduating with her Ontario Secondary School Diploma. She wants to figure out her post-secondary schooling later, and she will be spending a lot of time outside skiing, biking, and looking at trees. Maybe learning pottery. She thanks everyone who has influenced who she is today. Arina Volkova is graduating with their Ontario Secondary School Diploma. They will be attending Sheridan College for Architectural Technician, and she hopes to be one in the future, and she would like to say thanks to her family. Congratulations. Natalia Walters is graduating with their Ontario Secondary School Diploma. She plans to attend 1 year after work. She would like to thank her mother for helping her believe she can succeed even when she was struggling. And thank you to Miss Carrie and all my teachers for making me feel comfortable at my new school. Congratulations. Okay, Sophia used to be afraid of me, but not anymore. So Sophia Wang is graduating today with her Ontario Secondary School Diploma. She will be attending the University of Toronto to study life sciences. Good job. She would like to thank her family, friends, and teachers for supporting her throughout her high school career. She is going to stay on the stage and listen to all these awards. So she's getting the Excellence in Education Award, the Kevin Hamlin Arts Award, the Ontario Principals Council Award, and she's a valedictorian presented by CCI's 2022-2023 Student Council President, Natalie Skupchenko. Sorry, that's wrong. Okay. Bree Ward is graduating today with their Certificate of Accomplishment. She's not too sure what lies ahead for her, but she is looking forward to having new experiences. She would like to say a big thanks to her parents for their support and to Ms. Williamson, Mrs. Gruder, and all her teachers for helping her to get where she is today. Congratulations. Jay Watanay is graduating with their Ontario Secondary School Diploma. He plans to travel to Japan, then go to the University of Toronto for chemistry. He would love to thank Mr. Jones and Mr. Bell for inspiring him. Also, check out soundcloud.com/erebasu0. Jaden Whelan is graduating with his Ontario Secondary School Diploma. They intend to take a year off for work and travel. And he would like to thank all his family and friends. Congratulations. Matthew White is graduating with his Ontario Secondary School Diploma. He will be attending Ontario Tech University for electrical engineering. Matthew would like to thank family and friends. Congratulations. Congratulations to Macy Whiteside graduating with her Ontario Secondary School Diploma. Next year, she will be attending Western University to study media information and technoculture. Good luck. Congratulations. Lauren Wilson will be graduating with their Ontario Secondary School Diploma today. She will be attending Georgian College to study massage therapy. She would like to thank Mrs. Zago, Ms. Wyand, and Ms. Metherall for being such great teachers. Thank you to my mom and dad for everything. She's also the recipient of the Raise Bursary. Congratulations. Maya Wilson is graduating with her Ontario Secondary School Diploma. She plans to travel next year. Maya would like to thank Mrs. Zago for being the reason she attended school, along with Madre and Emily. Congratulations. Ryan Wilson is graduating with his Ontario Secondary School Diploma. He is planning to attend Georgian College to study paramedicine. Congratulations, Ryan. Matthew Witt is graduating with their Ontario Secondary School Diploma. He will be returning to CCI to take extra courses for university in Vancouver. Good luck. All right, so we have a new award established this year by Ignora. Former CCI graduate Richard Wilson is the vision behind Ignora and the manufacturing of architectural glass. Richard and his company recognize the role of skilled trades in the manufacturing industry and the importance of education and training. Ignora is dedicated to supporting youth as they prepare for post-secondary pathways. So Jocelyn Young has graduated with their Ontario Secondary School Diploma, as well as their SHSM Health and Wellness Red Seal Diploma. She will be attending the University of Guelph to study honors major human kinetics. Jocelyn plans to be a family practitioner in the future and would like to thank Mr. Lehman and a special thanks to Mr. Kruger for being an excellent mentor, and Timmy and Kimmy. Jocelyn is also the recipient of these awards, the CCI Entrepreneurship Award and the first Ignora Excellence in Manufacturing Award presented by Richard Wilson and Sherry Remnant. Congratulations. Tyga Young is graduating with his Ontario Secondary School Diploma. He will be attending the University of Calgary to study economics. Tyga is planning on joining the Dino Ski Team at the University of Calgary and hopes to pursue his dream of being an Olympic athlete. He would like to thank all the teachers who helped him over the years. Good luck. Colton Jovanovich has graduated with his Certificate of Accomplishment. He will not be returning to CCI, but he plans to attend his life. And that sounds fantastic. Sorry, there's more for Colton. He would like to thank all the teachers and EAs in life skills, especially Mr. McCarl, who has been with Colton since JK. And he will keep watching WWE wrestling and keeping McDonald's in business. No, not yet. And Colton, you get the Carpe Diem Award 2022. You're an amazing human. Congratulations. All right, I practiced his name for 2 hours, and he tried to teach me Mandarin. So this is, don't laugh at me, Chung, Chung Ho Jung. And he is graduating with his Ontario Secondary School Diploma. He will be attending Queen's University to study engineering and applied science. He would like to thank his family, mentor, teachers for positively influencing him and pushing him forwards. He thanks his friends for giving him enough chaotic experiences to last a decade or more. He would also like to give big thanks to his teachers in the music and technology department for encouraging him in his interests and passions. He is the recipient of a bunch of awards. So, the Deanna Prezio Scholarship, the Kevin Denbach Scholarship, the James W. Kecker Engineering Bursary, presented by Steve Taylor of Tatham & Associates, and the Ironside Law Firm Scholarship. Congratulations.
Well, you did it. Parents, can we give them another big round of applause? Thank you very much, Ms. Lanis, Mr. Funston, Ms. Bishop, for doing such a fantastic job announcing. The next presenter we have is your class valedictorian. So Sophia is no stranger to any of you. She's very hardworking, conscientious, enthusiastic, who demonstrated excellent leadership abilities through a variety of activities at CCI. She was a very active member of the CCI music program and contributed greatly to the successful leadership of Students Council over her 4 years. Come on up. You're all good. I'm just talking about you. It is awkward to be talked about, isn't it, when you're up here? Sophia had an exceptional work ethic and coupled with very consistent high academic achievements throughout her 4 years. She was nominated and voted by her peers to speak today as CCI's 2022 class valedictorian. Ladies and gentlemen, let's give her a warm welcome, Sophia Wang.
Hello, class of 2022. Before I commence my speech to my family, friends, and teachers, I would like to extend a warm thank you to you for your unconditional support these past and surely interesting 4 years of my life. Without you, I'm sure I would not be where I am today. So thank you. To my fellow graduates, I would like for you to take a look around you and appreciate those who have loved and supported you and are now here to celebrate you. So, of which is very well deserved, let's give us a big round of applause. Yeah. I would also like to thank all of you for choosing me to be your valedictorian and for believing in me to send you off with a final farewell worthy of this outstanding student body. So, without further ado, it is my honor to deliver the valedictory address. When I look back on these 4 years, what I won't remember is every math test I studied for or chemistry lab I did, because what I'll remember instead are the experiences I lived through that made our high school experience uniquely what it was. I'll always remember being in grade 9 and hearing about the teachers that you'd want to stay on the good side of. I'll remember the hardships of our aging building, given each troubling water issue that occurred. I'll remember being in grade 10 and hearing that we get an extra 2 weeks off after March break. I'll remember the days melting together as I woke up to my alarm at 7:59 and joined my Google Meet for 8 o'clock, and then proceeded to treat my class like a podcast. I'll remember every time they announced, "We're coming back in person," then back online, then back in person. I'll remember sweating at prom and the broken slushy machine, and now I'll remember standing here with all of you for the last time and being able to look back at these mishaps and laugh as we're so lucky to be gathered here together today. On behalf of the class of 2022, I think it's safe to say that we've been through a lot, especially considering these last 2 years. We lost almost half our high school experience, and now, here we are graduating. We might not know a whole lot about how the world works, like how to pay taxes, but what I think we do know from these years of uncertainty is how to embrace such change in the face of adversity. Because in the words of Darwin, it is not the strongest or most intelligent who will survive, but those who can best manage change. And in looking back on our shared experiences as a class, we have managed more change than I'm sure any of us could have imagined. So if we can learn to live through a pandemic, I'm sure whatever the next chapter of your life looks like for you, you will be more than okay. We've lived, and we've learned, we've adapted and overcome. We are the products of each challenge we've triumphed and each failure we've endured. So as you think about where you'll be in these years to come, please, do yourself a favor and be kind to yourself. Expect for there to be challenge and change along the way. Expect to make mistakes and have regrets. Because regardless of what happens, you will still remain the leader of your life, your ambitions, and your desires. These next years are for you to discover. And I trust that whatever you choose to do will be right as long as you have that same trust in yourself. So congratulations to my fellow classmates of the class of 2022. We finally made it. Thank you.
Come on, let's give her another big round of applause. So grads, we're almost there. You excited? Nervous? A little bit? That's okay. That's normal. This is the MC closing remarks, and I like this because Mr. Wallace left the paragraph blank. So that was my opportunity to just kind of address you as grads. Parents, I'll address you in a second, but I think it's more important to address the grads right now. Grads, I just want to encourage you to do one thing. I want you to wake up every day, and I want you to find some joy in your life. Because you've gone through 2 years where you didn't have to wake up. And let me give you a skill testing question. How was grad? Notice the silence. So for 2 years, as teachers, we sat there and we stared at letters on a screen. And it was like that, like the awkward silence that I'm giving you right now. That was 2 years of our life, right? I don't know about you, but I am happy to put those 2 years behind me. And every day I wake up now, I get really excited to wake up. And I said to the first group earlier, I said, you know, my grandfather was 96 years old when he passed, but he said to me, he said, Aaron, every time you wake up, you be thankful because the alternative is not so great. And you just want to take every day and run with it. Parents, this is where I'm going to turn to you. I want you to change the locks to your basement. I want you to seal those doors shut. I want you to encourage these kids to go. I want you to encourage them to run and to just take off and set sail and support them as best you can. It's the hardest thing you'll ever have to do. I sent my daughter off to school last year. I've never cried so much. A couple of tears of joy, not laughing, but a lot of tears of sorrow just seeing her go. But every time I look back now, all I see is just great progress. And I know you're going to see the same with your kids. So lock the doors, buy a house without a basement, do something, but encourage them to just run with it. You know, there were some great speeches that I read. Jay, as some of our music guys, I love the marketing blitz. That was fantastic, putting your own little soundtrap push there. As a music guy, I really appreciate that. A couple were going, Tyga, I think you were going off into economics. If it makes you feel better. I minored in economics. The only problem is I focused on the demand side and forgot about the supply. So please focus on both sides of the curve as you go through. But to our entire graduating party, I really do want to encourage all of you to just run, have fun, okay? Live your dreams, and know that it's never too late to be educated. Not that I'm bragging, but I just graduated college today myself. I'm serious. I did a college degree, and I graduated today, too. So excited. And you know what? It's one of those things. You're never too old to go back to school. And truthfully, I did better now than I ever did back then. And the only thing I remember back from my high school was two things. I took Latin. Are there any parents out there that took Latin? Yeah, remember the good old days? They said, you want to go into medicine? You should take Latin. I said, okay. The only thing I remember are two things, semper ubi, sub ubi. Any guesses? Yes, always wear underwear. I remember that. And the other thing I remember from my Latin class was nulli secundus. And nulli secundus, anybody know? I heard it out here. Second to none. And that is a good thing to remember. And I've always said when you're out there trying to survive in the world, don't settle for being anything but the best, okay? And the last thing I'm going to say before I get the hook has to do with my pride that I'm feeling to hear so many of you going off into the apprenticeship programs. I said earlier, I've done 21 years of these here. Then I had my own high school, my university grads, my kindergarten graduation. I think there was 27 in total grads. And I've never seen so many kids going off into the trades. And that's awesome. Again, not to turn this into a long story, but when I was 16 years old, my father, he worked at GM, and he worked in the foundry, and he said, Aaron, I'm going to take you to HE double hockey sticks. I can't say the word. And he took me to the foundry, down to the bottom of the plant where they poured the iron. And it was, I think it was 120 degrees, dirty. And he said, this is a great place to work. You can make $35 an hour, great pension plan, everything. I was scared. I ran out of there. I said, I am going to school for anything, but I'm not working there. Am I thankful that my dad worked there his entire career? Yes. Okay. My one daughter, she wants to become a firefighter, but I said, you got to go out and become a carpenter first. She's like, I'm all over it. And you know what? These trades are going to take you places. These degrees that you're talking about are going to take you places. And these exciting year gap years that you want to take, do it. You're going to be working for the rest of your life. You might as well have fun now while you're young. Okay? So, live life, run with it, have fun, and you'll be super, super successful. Closing remarks, back on script. Here we go. Grads, to avoid congestion, please exit the gym to your left. You will head to the cafeteria. There will be spots for commencement pictures with your guests. It's actually quite nice. Spend time out there. There's going to be a specific order to our recessional. Graduates are going to be leaving from the back to the front under the direction of Mr. Koala and Mr. Lehman. Next will be our platform guests, followed by our staff and dignitaries, then parents exiting from the front to the back rows. I don't know what I just said there. Many thanks to everybody who's been involved in organizing this commencement ceremony. The other thing, graduates, is you should be very thankful for a very, very supportive community that you live in. You have your mayors of Collingwood and Wasaga here with you, but you have community donors that, I don't know, I'm not going to do the math, but I'm guessing it's anywhere between $50,000 to $100,000 worth of sponsorships and scholarships and bursaries that are here to see you succeed. So there's something special about a handwritten note. Take time. Write them a note. Tell them how successful you're going to be. Tell them that you're nulli secundus. Okay? That's your job. Back on script. Grads, the worst part about high school graduation was what? The hat. Let's get the hats. You ready? Here we go. We're almost ready. Parents, get your cameras ready. This is the moment every graduating student looks forward to. Everybody's graciously fixing their hair quickly. On the count of three, get your cameras ready. We're going to do the big countdown. Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, children of all ages, here we go. I now give you the graduating class of Collingwood Collegiate in 3, 2, 1. Hey, there we go. Congratulations, everybody. Grads, enjoy the rest of your time together. Parents, thank you so much for your time. We will start with our recessional. Please follow the direction of Mr. Koala and Mr. Lehman. Thank you to all our party guests and hosts and awards recipients and bursaries and scholarships. Thank you so much for all your time, everybody. Parents, again, we'd encourage you to spend time with your kids in the cafeteria and outside. Beautiful weather today. Thank you all for being wonderful parents and supporting your kids here. And congratulations for an excellent year.